Greetings and welcome to another episode of the Planetary Persuader. I am Cosmic Kev, your host. And this is for the week beginning Friday the 20th of November through the 27th of November. So this is covering Thanksgiving for Americans. And it's also covering a full moon, which occurs the day before Thanksgiving, this Wednesday. And it is at a 3 degrees Gemini and 20 minutes, I imagine. In Vedic astrology, I'm not really sure because I haven't looked it up whether this is the Kritika full moon or this is the Rohini full moon. It's very, I'm gonna bet it's Rohini though. I'm feeling it, but I know it's really close either way, so I don't want to make any assumptions. But what we could say though is in either event, you know, that's a Venus ruled, you know, Taurus moon in Vedic astrology, Gemini moon in Western. It's going to deal with a lot of news. Will be about finances and communication and how we deal with it. So the full moon, Wednesday, 2:44 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. So adjust to where you are. That means if you're on the east coast of the United States, or on Eastern Standard Time, you would say that is happening at 5:44 p.m. So you know, if you're north of 37 degrees, you probably get a little glimpse of that big moon right as sundown hits. Yeah, so you'll get the nice fat shot as it's peaking. All right. So, besides that, what other wonderful things are happening? Well, Sunday, the sun goes into Sagittarius Sunday morning at 7:26 a.m. So just a little after sunrise, sun's going into Sagittarius in Western astrology on November 22nd. So, on that day, the moon will be in Aries, so it's fire on fire. Moon's going to conjoin Uranus that day, so it's a stimulating and exciting day for all. And, Thanksgiving, looks like the moon's in Gemini. There's a nice moon square Jupiter at 7:24 p.m., and that's like where you say to yourself, I can't believe I ate the whole thing. You know, that's what that aspect is. So be really careful about eating the whole thing. And then, you know, you stuff in dessert afterwards because Venus trines the moon just minutes later. It sounds like it'll be okay. Sounds like everything's going to be all right. What's the difference between Scorpio and Sagittarius? Well, you know, in Scorpio time, we're concerned about our own vulnerability, possibility of death. We're definitely preoccupied with sex and the opportunities or lack of opportunities therein. Sagittarius, it's just pure opportunities for anything. A lot of games. There's a There's a certain kind of enthusiasm, fanaticism. It's key phrases I visualize. So setting out our goals, we're starting out on Sunday with Saturn and the Sun conjoining, will be conjoining actually for the first week. And so you know, up until the weekend. So, you know, on Sunday, next weekend, we'll have Saturn and Sun conjoin, but we're in that place where we're dealing with this conflict of where do I shine personally with my abilities and what do I need to do to get, and what do I need to get rid of to be humble and just, you know, because that's what Saturn's asking. So let's do it. Sign by sign, eventually your sign on this week's edition of The Planetary Persuader. So let's start out here. Greetings, Aries. Welcome to your horoscope. So we've got Mars in Libra right now, and Venus is there too. So, you know, Venus and Mars in the seventh house, I think Western astrologers would generally say this is a good thing. You know, they would say, take good care, do good things. You know, seventh house, as well as the house of marriage, house of contracts, it can be the house of open enemies. So, you know, there's an element of confrontation, but there's also an element of resolve and sweetness. And for heaven's sake, it's in the constellation, you know, it's in Libra, so we think of it tends to be diplomatic and sweet and all those type of things. Okay. That's part of it. Jupiter in Virgo, you know, it's like sixth house, this is a gymnasium. And, you know, Aries, I've said this before, it's time for you to get in shape. Looks like we got Moon in Pisces this weekend. Of course, Moon will be in your first house on beginning Saturday morning. So Saturday morning, Moon will be in Aries. That's an extra pump it up. And whatever relationship and personal ambition issues you have, they will be revealed this weekend. Keep it all lighthearted, you know, have fun with your siblings and Thanksgiving, that kind of thing. Well, greetings, Taurus, and welcome to your horoscope. And yeah, I know, I shaved, I know, it's so silly, but I'm going to let it grow back again. But I had to do this baby face thing for just a little bit, you know. For just several weeks. So we're gonna have a moon in Taurus Monday morning and on Tuesday, so the 23rd, 24th. That's gonna be your power days, so to speak. Now that the sun's over in Sagittarius, it's like it's moved into your eighth house. It went from this partnership and thing to undeserved rewards. So some good things are happening to you, some bad things are happening, but it's really not so much because of you. It's mainly all because of other people. So it's humbling because you realize you're not in control. Now, Venus and Mars are in the sixth house, so it's about sprucing up your house, your workplace, being a better team player. Those are themes. Be careful, you know, when things go, because, you know, tempers can sometimes fly. And Saturn in your eighth house is sort of ego crushing. Well, hello, Gemini, and welcome to your horoscope. So, we got a moon in Gemini Wednesday morning. And it's going to be full. So, moon goes into Gemini 9:15 a.m. And then at 2:44 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. The full moon peaks, so I imagine, you know, Tuesday night, big full moon, another big fat moon Wednesday night, even Thanksgiving, moon will be looking pretty full, provided, you know, I mean, hopefully we won't even see it. Hopefully we'll be covered with clouds and everything will be all nicely sealed in. For Gemini, in your horoscope, how do we expand our sense of tribe and family? You know, fall, you're going to have Thanksgiving Day, day after Thanksgiving, at least the morning after Thanksgiving. Morning of Black Friday, moon will still be in Gemini, so. In this 2.5 day period, you're kind of more the focus, you know, because you're the disseminator of interesting information, and we never know which side of you is going to show up at the table, so this will be interesting there. Now, Sagittarius is your opposite, so now that the sun's moving into Sagittarius, it's going to be more of a focus on relationships, more of a focus of where you want to be in your life romantically, in a partnership. And then Venus and Mars are in your fifth house, so it's like you're in a creative role. You're actually doing pretty good. You're having fun. I hope so. And if not, it's your own damn fault. Hello, Cancer. Welcome to your horoscope. What do we got today? Well, you know, sun moving into Sagittarius. So Sagittarius, your sixth house. So this is health issues, especially northern hemisphere this time of year. You're cooped up inside more. There's a little more cold weather, wet weather, what have you. And, you know, you're more susceptible. So, you know, you wash your hands more. The other thing is when you are feeling good, help other people. Number one, that helps your health karma. And number two is work out. You know, if you live in an area where there's available snow, I'd say go cross-country skiing. If you have a gym where you can swim, go swimming. Do yoga, something, you know, or just take long walks, but something to just stay invigorated. You know, it's a time when you need to use your invigoration skills. And then Friday, late morning, moon will be in your sign. So when we talk about next week, the other half of the Thanksgiving weekend, it's all about you. All about you. You'd be dragging everybody to the antique store and stuff. I know your motive operandi. No. Greetings, Leo. Welcome to your horoscope. So, this is a really good time of year for you. I mean, you love it because you, by nature, are a generous person and you're known for being a generous sign. So, sun's in your fifth house. Fifth house is like a Leo house. You're like, hey, I can do this. It's like about playing with kids. It's about having love affairs. It's about being a teacher, a performer, learning more, traveling, moving on. So much dharma, so much good fortune. It's a good house, you know, it really is. And so that's helping out your transit. I mean, the Scorpio thing is cool because you know who's got your back. You know who your family is during that period. I think, you know, your better days will probably be with the Aries moon. It'll probably be, you know, the weekend, Saturday, Sunday. Look to that for more high-powered fun and hijinks. Well, hello, Virgo. And welcome to your horoscope. Okay, so now you got this Rahu thing happening, this north node. Like, what is Rahu? Yeah, well, it's a Sanskrit word for the North Node. I like it better. North Node sounds just so dorky. But it's okay because, you know, obviously I'm an astrology dork because I'm here doing this. And so we've got North Node reaching towards Jupiter. It's not really there yet. I mean, the real conjunction of this is going to be in January. And, like, see, the North Node gives us ambition that has no bottom, and that's not really healthy. You know, and I mean, we're at the tail end of the Vishaka Nakshatra as far as where the sun's transiting right now, and that's about taking over areas, folks. It's a very Jupiter-ruled, and it can really create ambition stress. So I'm going to say, Virgo, don't be so focused on ambition stress. Now that the sun's moving through Sagittarius in your fourth house, focus on your parents. Focus on your things that make you happy, the people that you consider to be part of your tribe. I mean, that's what's going to be good for you. That's what's going to work right now. Mercury's transiting your third house. Your communication is good. People are listening to what you have to say. There is no problem there. We will get Mercury will move, though, over into your fourth house, which helps with the memory. So Mercury in the fourth, in Sagittarius, you're able to have better recall. Which, you know, I mean, Gore Vidal used to call it the United States of amnesia. There's a reason for that, folks. I think he said that before chemtrails, too. All right. Which is really geoengineering. All right. That's the proper term. Greetings, Libra. Welcome to your horoscope. Okay. So, well, that's one of those, yeah, you're right. That's one of those words. Oh, my gosh. It wasn't about like a Super Bowl star or something. That's okay. You can talk about that. And yeah, yeah. I gotcha. All right. So, Libra, greetings. Welcome to your horoscope. So, okay, we're tailing in Scorpio time, which was all about kind of making money and finding your values and your resources. So now we're in Sagittarius. It's about your community. It's about your environment, what you're looking at. Looking at a bunch of leaves on the ground is what you're looking at. It's a bunch of work. It's also communiques with friends, especially people you went to school with, college and before. So that's a good thing. And it's really just a time where you can make something with your hands, do a little poetry, songwriting, storytelling, whatever. Third house is good with all of that. You know, you're sharing information. There's a lot of neighborhood gossip. You know, that's part of the whole Sagittarius. Now that Mercury's in your third house, you're able to communicate. In fact, Mercury in Sagittarius overall is a better Mercury, folks, because a Mercury with a face is able to express itself. Mercury's like Mercury in Scorpio. Nobody's like, it's all clammed up. Don't say it. You know what I mean? They're too sensitive to hear that. Yeah, gotcha. Oh, it's all personal. Mercury in Sagittarius, more like, out with it. We are so bored with this interesting information, but we'll say it anyway. Well, greetings, Scorpio. Welcome to your horoscope, and happy birthday to those of you born, you know, Scorpios born the last 3 days of Scorpio. All right, you know, I'm going to give a birthday shout out to my friend El Shivato, turning 65, so that's a big deal. Here we go. I'm looking at this period of just like releasing. You know, we had so much ambition in the last several weeks, and this week we get to just kind of release all of that and just say, what are our real values? How can I put on a new face? How can I express myself in a good way? How can I fulfill my appetite, my desires, my needs, my material needs? So material needs go way more into focus. Now it's Saturn's in your second house. You see where the lack is, but also through discipline, you learn to be more sustainable. So Saturn in Sagittarius for Scorpios, you know, is not a bad thing, okay? It can help. And so that's something to look at right now there. And also just, you know, limits. I think the worst part is you might have limits on family issue things that are just harder to deal with. You know, it's like, oh boy, that's not news I wanted. You know, but on the bright side, you know, by next weekend, you know, moon will be, well, I mean, let's start with this weekend. We're looking good. We've got a Pisces moon tonight if you're watching Friday. And so your creative mojo is still on, and it's water on water, baby. So the magic is here. You know, this is where I live, this is the last weekend where the leaves are going to be on the trees and it's going to still look really pretty and awesome. But after this, ooh, it gets all stark, you know. And so, but you know, there's Christmas lights and yada, yada. Mars and Venus in your 12th house, you know. Sometimes 12th house can be pleasures of the bed. So, you know, the karma of an affair. You think nobody knows about it? You got to be kidding yourself. Maybe, I mean, you know, if you live in New York, I got you. Nobody knows about it. Nobody cares, all right? All right. But if you live in little old Ashland, where everybody's so liberal, but, you know, they're listening to everything you're doing. Oh, my gosh. You know, things can get, emotions can fly. People can get all whooped up around. You know? So in your values, you're, like, going to show yourself to be, like, more disciplined. That's your new move, Scorpio. The disciplined Scorpio. You know, I miss the wild beast, right? But hey, you gotta, you know, go when you can. Greetings, Sagittarius. Welcome to your horoscope. Happy birthday for those of you having birthdays this week in the early first 5 degrees of Sagittarius. So sun goes in your signs Sunday morning, the 22nd. So early born, you know, those born before 7:26 or whatever it is on that day. 7:26, yeah. If you're born before that, you're Scorpio. Born after that, you're Sagittarius. In Western astrology, okay. Veda trip, you're all Scorpios, you know. Hands down. At least sun part of you. So, you know, Jupiter's in Virgo, so it's midheaven, it's career life. You got to expand your career, but you got Saturn there too, squaring on one side, and then you've also got Neptune in your home life. And this illusion or this weakness that's in the home, this drug, this religion, this, you know, sandy foundation that has water and is too close to the river, or whatever it is. There's a lot of tension. It's like your discipline and being able to get rid of fluff, super important right now. Super important. That's it. Because, and you got good friends. You got people in high places. This is going to be good. And your communication's good because, you know, Mercury's in your first house. So you've got an ear and people hear what you have to say. It sounds good. It's time to make sense. Hello, Capricorn, and welcome to your horoscope. So, you know, Scorpio time is like the social life, and that was really fun, and it still is. I imagine you will go out and socialize Friday night, maybe. You know, maybe even early Saturday morning. But, you know, the vibe changes, you know. It like goes to a place where you're more responsible to your family and your karma. You know, this is your karma 4.5 weeks coming up. That means you're dealing with your spiritual life. You're dealing with all the things you did the last 11 months as they come to rest, you know. And so it's really a time where it's easy to be unconscious. It's easy to mess up. But if you pray for others, you isolate yourself, you do good deeds to help those who are isolated, everything gets good. And then you're able to break into your new year come late December. Just excellent. Hello, Aquarius. Welcome to your horoscope. Okay, so like, Sagittarius is ruler of your 11th house. So, I mean, going to a ball game with your friends, that is so 11th house. Sagittarius ruled 11th house. So doing things like that, that's socializing. Playing games. There's like an element of gaming in that 11th house. You really like to do that, play games. And because Mercury's in Sagittarius and it's in the 11th house, which is a really good house for Mercury in that it relays information, but you don't want to be too much of a gossip. If you have older siblings, they may be more of a figure in your life, helpful friends. That's all part of the transit. And I mean, of course, you're gonna love it. You know, you're gonna love Thanksgiving. It's gonna be in your fifth house. You're gonna have fun. You're gonna be cool. Everything's cool with you. Hello, Pisces, and welcome to your horoscope. Okay, so we're starting out today, Friday, with the moon in Pisces. This is beautiful, and it's the end of Scorpio time, so it's water on water, very trine, good feeling. It's actually Vedic Pisces moon, Vedic Scorpio sun, so always. We're here experiencing some moksha, you know, some release, some spiritual essence where the material vibe can be washed away by our imaginations and our creativity. That sounds pretty cool. And with Neptune and Chiron in the first house, you're ready to do cool things. Jupiter in the seventh house, you attract people of a high caliber. Some of them are drunks and drug addicts. Some of them are swindlers and liars. Some of them are the most high people, the sweetest gurus, benefactors you'll ever meet. You just have to be careful and know the difference. Your libido is up. You need somebody to be with for the winter time with that Venus and Mars in the 8th house. There's just no getting around it. But you also have to show yourself to be more responsible now. Because, you know, the focal point for you is that Saturn in Sagittarius. You know, you're showing that you can be a leader. You can get rid of bad stuff, and you can show yourself to be reliable, timely, and be able to live by the rules. You know, that's the deal for someone who's enigmatic and not wanting to, you know, just commit to anything, be a slippery fish. Hey, this is your time to get real and say, this is where I draw the line, this is what I do. So I hope that you enjoyed your horoscope this week. I'm looking forward to being with you next week. We'll do this again on the Planetary Persuader with your host, Cosmic Kev.
Citizen Television.